Oh boy, oh boy. Kaiju number 8 looks ass. And I've said this from the very beginning, from the moment that we saw the character designs, these are things that I, from the very beginning, didn't like. Now, it's a bit of a random video, but hear me out and let's get into it. Enjoy. So Kaiju 8 has been a bit of a series that I wanted to kind of peep for a while because it had like this Nini and Noelle type of character and it looked cute and something that, hey, I could maybe get into. But I was like, hey, the anime is coming out, so I'll peep when the anime comes out. And then they dropped the character designs and boy did they look fucking ass. And I was not the only person to ever say this at all. There was threads, there was Reddit posts, like here's one for example, and you can see the differences of the characters. The guy in the white hair looked like he got nerfed the absolute most, and it just wasn't appealing. And I never really went out of my way to ever go look up who did the character designs because it just looked like the most generic NPC faces with different colored hairs and this girl with like these twin tails, whatever, right? It doesn't really matter. It didn't look good. It looked ass. And I was like, you know what? I'll be open-minded. I'll wait until the PV comes out. And then the PV comes out and it was done by One Republic and Youngblood. And it was like, oh, I had hopes. I was like, you know what? Maybe it's different. And the music just wasn't hitting either. And because it just sounded like, it didn't sound hype. You know, the visuals were trying to, you know, the kaijus look great. The backgrounds look nice, but the character designs looked ass. And then you had like this background music, which again, to each their own. But for me, it just wasn't it. And then something about it was going to be live streamed on like X or Twitter, so like that was different too, and I was very interested to see how that was going to be marketed. But to me, it just didn't hit any of the nails on the head whatsoever, for me personally. And I just left it at that, and it was just a show that I just wasn't going to go out my way to peep, to be honest with you. There's only two series which I'm somewhat peeping, and that shows Akura Family, because I got somewhat investment in that. And the anime seems to be mediocre to okay at best. And then you have Windbreaker, which is okay in animation, but the story seems ass to me. Just like seems like a high and low ripoff. But again, you know, maybe it will get better the more that I watch it. I don't know. But those are the only two things that I'm watching. Kaiju 8 is definitely just not going to be one of those. So anyway, my disdain has already been made. I've made my opinion on Twitter like months ago, whatever, right? So here's the thing about me and Twitter, right? Is that when I make a tweet, usually it's just for shits and giggles. Either I'll say something that is contextually like sound, or like, hey, here's some information, and or hey, here's an opinion. And then there's other times where I'm just shooting the shit, right? Unless it's a YouTube video, that's when I'm actually like really serious, because it's important that I use my audience for good. And Twitter is just kind of like, just meh, you know, here's what I'm doing today, whatever. So yeah, I get a message from my friend Jonathan. Oh wait, hold on, pause, scroll up. Anyway, and he sends me this screenshot of Kaiju 8, and I'm like, ain't no way that's a real frame. And he went, I hope not. And then he found the original post and he said, shaking my head, and I went, for fuck's sake. Now, of course, I watched the clip, which is here. You know, for the majority of the part, it looks okay, but that was noticeable to me. Like, I was like, I knew the moment. The moment that I saw it, I knew where it was. And I thought it was funny. I had a bit of a chuckle, and I posted it. Naturally, this was a mistake, because, oh boy, 41,000 views, 51 quote tweets, and 530. You know it's bad. Like, fucking hell. Like, here's the thing for me, right? It's like, I went out my way to see who the character designer was after this, because I was just like, God, this is just so bad. Like, who designed these characters? Because it piqued my interest again. And I looked at the character list, and I was like, it's Nishio Tetsuya. And I've said this from the get-go. I don't care what all these other fucking animators want to say or whatever. This guy, you know, he was good on Ghost in the Shell. Great character designs on Naruto too. But the moment Boruto hit, it's like it was this washed out, low detail. And you know what? I'm not even the one to say it. Like, I'm not even being a hater. Boruto fans said that these character designs are just dead. They're just, there's no detail. The colours are washed, line art's very, like, shady at best, and it's just dead. It's actually just dead you know, I was like, you know what, it's whatever, but then it is what it is, it's Boruto, it's like, who's watching it, right? Clearly fucking no one, because like, that's why the anime is like, flopped. I don't care what anyone is saying, we look at the TV tech, just shut up, right? Then Kaiju 8 comes out with the character designs, and everything makes sense, because like, I'm looking at the eyes, and the eyes are very distinct, and you can tell somewhat that it's niche, but he fell off. I'm sorry, but as a animation director, you know, key animation, all that sort of stuff, he's good, but as a character designer, ever since Boruto, to me, fell the fuck off. Even Vampire in the Garden, it's like, brother, where is your individuality? You're just a Kishimoto ripoff through and through, and I can see it in Kaiju 8 by the eyes, and it's not for him anymore. Like, I don't know why, I don't know what happened, but to me, stop this man from character designing. And that's not me being a dick, you know, I'm not attacking the guy first and foremost, I'm not going up to him or sending people his way. I didn't even mention him by name, right? That's what I just said, the Boruto character, because there's like three of them, right? So, you know, at the end of the day, it's just me throwing out an impulsive thought out into the ether that, you know, could have got 20 likes and people could have moved the fuck on. But of course, you know, with everything on Twitter is that you can do something really great. You can put up a really nice in-depth post and it can get 10 views. But the moment you say something remotely, something that goes against somebody's thoughts, then that shit gets quote tweeted to all hell. And it's really weird because it's like this bullying mentality of like, we will silence you because we don't like this take, whatever it is. Anyway, but can someone tell me where in this tweet whatsoever do I mention animation? Is it an in-between frame? Yes, it is. Is it a goofy picture? Yes, it is. Why did I post it? It's fucking funny. You know, the character designs, ass in general, it's a well-renowned, you know, thing that people have said many a times over. This is not something that is new. I'm just gooning, right? I think the guy should stop character designing because he's either a Kishimoto clone or just whatever this is, right? Because he just ain't working, right? With whatever Boruto was for character designs and whatever Kaiju 8 is for character designs, it just ain't it. It just is not it for me, and he should just stop touching anime if he's going to keep character design. That's my opinion, right? You can be like, well, I don't agree. And people went out of their way to be like, posting an in-between, making fun of people's works to get some interaction. Again, like, I'm sorry, but if you drew that and you handed it in and you think that that's acceptable, it's not. That's why we have, and here's the thing that I kind of wanted to talk about. There was a video I did a really long time ago, and it was like, you know, it's on screen somewhere, and I kind of, you know, compared the openings to One Piece, Naruto, and Bleach, and I kind of gave my critique on a lot of bad frames or bad art within these openings, right? And I said what I did and didn't like. And I got a lot of shit from animators. And still, you know, anytime anyone on Twitter or X or on YouTube mentions anything remotely about an in-between frame looking bad, they're like, oh, it's an in-between, bro. It's an in-between. Stop being a dickhead, blah, 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 blah. And I'm just like, wait, if we are supposed to just accept bad art as an in-between frame, or an in-between frame is bad art and it's not to be expected to be good, then why the fuck in Blu-rays do they make corrections? The staff know that it's a bad art, unless it's a smear, unless it's a high action pack movement where the face is supposed to be distorted to match into a fluidity of another frame, then that makes sense. But when it's literally a static shot that isn't going into something else and is just genuinely disproportioned for the sake of being disproportioned, and it's just bad art, then let's recognize something as bad and let's either critique it or take the piss out of it so it gets fixed for a home cinema release, right? Home cinema. Home release. It's home cinema. Because I don't know, if for some reason, if for the 10 years that I've been on Twitter, you cannot, for the life of you, take the piss out of bad art in anime, because animators cry for some reason. Like, you cannot talk about something being just bad art. Oh, well, you're not an animator, you don't know what, it's bad. It's bad art. Just deal with it. It's bad art. Just do better, right? You can never critique the animators, ever. You can never critique it. It's like sacrilege. Oh, well, why don't you try and animate? If I see bad art, it's fucking bad, right? If I draw a picture and post it on Twitter and it's a bad picture and people say, oh, it's gas, then you're just gaslighting me and you're just lying to me. Like, there's encouragement and then there's lying. What's bad is bad. This is why, you know, they correct things. multiple times. If it wasn't bad, then it wouldn't be corrected. So let's stop with this ego. What would you call it? An ego? Stop with these inflated egos and just deal with it. It's bad art. There's a main takeaway I want to take from this, but I kind of wanted to joke about it a little bit because I was getting a lot of traction from it, and I was like, fuck it, I'm going to make money from you if you're going to keep taking the piss. But, you know, some people posted pictures of, like, Ichigo from the Thousand Year Blood War arc, and it is, you know, it is what it is. The Blu-ray's made so many corrections, so it's like, yeah, there's bad art here and there. I've never once, you know, defended bad art in Bleach, like, ever. I've even critiqued it myself in the Blu-rays, in the Blu-ray correction videos that I do. This is not something I'm going to get offended by, and I don't know why people think, oh, but if this was Bleach, he'd be defending it. Like, no, you've basically you know of me for like 1 second, and then you just don't know my character at all. You've just assumed something. You've made a quote tweet maliciously to get me bullied or attacked, and you stand on this moral high ground that you are in fact better than me, or are a better person because I said I don't like a character design. Had it ever come to the notion that maybe you are also equally an arsehole? And then there's obviously, like, you know, Boruto fans, of course, because they can never ever correct you without slandering your character, a racist pedo, of course. Pictures of Ichigo, like, this is supposed to accomplish something. I'm apparently fucked in the head for calling Nishio the Boruto character designer, which he is. And then, of course, I got told by this user Rockstar to go hang myself, to which my awesome homies responded and reported the person saying, what the fuck, you're sick, get help. Looks like someone got hurt over a cartoon picture. Yeah, like, Boruto fans or something. Yeah, like, the amount of times that I mention Boruto or anything remotely related to Boruto, the amount of attacks that I get maliciously, like, I mean, not even maliciously, but it's like, the death threats, the allegations, like the defamation of character, and I'm supposed to sit here like they are the righteous ones, and it's just quite funny to me. This is, you know, you have so many people. I got called an engagement farmer. And the takeaway that I want to give from this is that there are thousands of people every single day on Twitter that slander Kubo, slander Kishimoto, slander Oda, because fans keep fighting each other about whose series is better, like Kubo copied Naruto, or Naruto copied Hunter x Hunter, or One Piece, Gear 5 is goofy, and, you know, the animators are ass, and it's always like artist flexing. But the moment that I say that the Boruto character designer needs to stop fucking touching anime in terms of character designs, right, I'm the bad guy. But the thousands, not thousands, that's a bit of an over-exaggeration, but the tens to close to hundreds of people who interacted with me, who, when you click on their profile, are literally slandering manga artists to boost their series up, is ironically the virtuous ones. So, all I have to say or take away from this video is, one, Kaiju 8 character designs are bad. The in-between was funny as fuck. Big derp picture. There's plenty of Bleach derp pictures out there which are quite funny. It's just a high moment. And I do think that Nishio, if I say his name right, he needs to be honest, change his art style. To me, I think that's a valid opinion. But some people like it, so that's all to you. But, you know, I think it's doing Kaiju 8 a massive disservice. And I think, you know, with the opening and ending not being that great, in my opinion, the marketing for it, and then the character designs, I think it has been extremely nerfed for the popularity that Kaiju 8 could have had, if not more than what it already has, right? And that's, I think, important, is presentation of an anime. Does it look good? Sometimes it does, but the first thing that's going to sell people is character designs, first and foremost. It is a big thing. And look, I'm not going to lie. Yuzakura family, that character design, I think, is doing a disservice to the manga as well, but at least it's bog standard. You know, I don't think it is insulting to the IP, whereas I think with Kaiju 8, it is a little bit disrespectful to the IP, but again, that's just my view on things. Also, just to end off this video, just because an animator disagrees with me on Twitter does not make their opinion on objective fucking visualization better than mine. So I can't have an opinion on whether something looks good because an animator said that they disagree with me. The brain, people, like, think. Anyway, I just got back from work. I hope you enjoyed this quick little video, whereas there wouldn't have been one. So I hope you have a good day. You guys, of course, have this fun. JaymesHanson, as always, people. I don't know what the conclusion was to this video. Peace out.